there's so many things that AMED, you know, Army Medicine can offer any of the medical professionals that come in. So first, the reason many of us join the Army is because the Army will pay for our training. We'll pay for whether it's school or residency programs or such. You know, the ability to have that financial support through a pretty critical time of your life is no small thing. We talk about money being, you know, sometimes we kind of push it off, but at that point in your life when you're young, usually already in debt, but you desperately want to become a medical professional, the fact that the Army is willing to provide the finances to support that dream is no small thing. But then after that, once you're in, you begin to realize that the professional practice within Army medicine is really second to none. As a physician, you're allowed to you know, really practice medicine in almost a pure way. If you don't want to necessarily worry about the business aspects of medicine, you don't have to. You can concentrate on your patients. We have world-class facilities with world-class state-of-the-art medicine occurring in them. And so not only does the Army provide this environment, but it also provides all the resources for you to practice in the way that you want to practice. Finally, and I think most importantly, is that we do deploy. We deploy with our soldiers as they go down range, and we get to practice our profession in places probably we never would have dreamed of. But you begin to realize how important your profession is to these soldiers you're taking care of. They do what they do primarily because we're there to help them if they need it. And that kind of professional experience feeling is not something you really encounter anywhere else. So I think that there's things that are very similar, but I think also things that are very different. As a neonatologist, day-to-day in the NICU, what we do and how we do it is very, very similar to the civilian sector. I think the big difference and a big benefit is that as a neonatologist in the Army, I really don't have to worry about the business of running the NICU. I'm allowed to do the things that I feel are appropriate, take care of patients the way I want to, not have to worry about insurance companies and how is this getting paid for and are the parents going to get a big bill at the end of all of this. So it really allows me to practice medicine in the best way I know how without really having to worry about some of those business aspects that my civilian colleagues really have to deal with every day. So first biggest benefit is the people you work with every day, by far. And it's the people you work with and the people you work for. So the real reason I've stuck around for 30 plus years is because I cannot imagine a finer group of people to work with every day who are completely dedicated to the mission of what we're currently doing at that time and completely dedicated to the patients that we're taking care of. And then to add on to that, every day we get to take care of America's heroes and their families and do things for them to honor the sacrifices they're making for us. And so it's really this combination of the people you work with and the people you're working for that makes coming to work every day in the Army, in the AMED, something that I look forward to and that I'll dearly miss when it's all over. So actually I joined AMED coming out of West Point. So I was, in my initial journey in the Army started at West Point, graduated from West Point class of 1986. And in my time there began to look at the various options for where was my place in the Army. And one of them was being, you know, an Army physician. And so spending a little time looking into both what that would mean for me, but then also thinking through, okay, is this, you know, making a decision to become a physician, whether you're in the Army or not, is one of those decisions that is generally a lifelong one. So, you know, was this the path I wanted to take? And kind of in that contemplation, really with a lot of help from mentors, particularly my parents, walk through that being a doctor would be an excellent path for me to follow. And then in particular, being a doctor in the Army, an Army physician would allow me to not only serve others as a physician, but also serve my country. So I think it's funny. I thought about this, and I think the thing that I found that I thought was the most rewarding is two things. One is what I would call just the chronologic age award. There is a period of time. Actually, it's still true that I'm the most senior neonatologist in the military. So I mean, I've hung around for the longest time. So that's that's certainly rewarding. But I think more importantly, there was a period of time about a couple of years ago, the military has three neonatology training programs. And for a period of time, all of those programs were headed by neonatologists that I had either trained within my training program or had been a part of their training as a senior neonatologist. So that was, I think, very rewarding to see essentially the people that I had a role helping them become neonatologists, now really running the neonatology services and programs within all three of the services. So I think hang in there. You know, when you're in training, when you're working those very long hours, sometimes it is easy to forget. You know, really how rewarding this all is, because you're tired, you're busy. And I would say really, you know, take a little bit of time to reflect on not just kind of where your career is heading, but time to reflect on these families that you're getting a chance to interact with, your teammates in the NICU, the nurses, the respiratory therapy staff, the lab techs, the whole team. Really take some time to appreciate those people and the team and the teamwork you're doing, rather than, you know, always focusing on kind of what the next hill is you need to climb. So I was born and raised in a town named Riverview, Michigan, which is a suburb of Detroit. Had brother and sister, mom and dad. Dad was a high school principal, mom worked at a bank. And I joined the Army at 17 when I went to West Point. Riverview is a great town to grow up in, lots of friends, lots of people kind of looking out after you and helping you along. And it was a great start for me to eventually transition into the Army. There's two things that I think are really, really cool about being a neonatologist. So first is, it is intensive care medicine. So you're busy, you're doing things, actively making decisions and taking actions to make your patients better, which is a lot of, it's very rewarding. You feel like you're doing something important every day. But the second part about being a neonatologist, which is just as rewarding, is the fact that most of our babies, after they go through that kind of intensive care period, end up being in the NICU for several weeks. And during that several weeks, you became, well, during the first part, but certainly during the second part, you become very close to the families and kind of get to be a part of their journey having their first baby. And as you've gone through that kind of really scary part for all of us at the beginning, and then the baby's recovering and getting essentially bigger and getting ready to go home, you get to really bond with the families themselves. So you kind of get the benefits of both. An intensive care type of practice, but also a primary care practice where you're building relationships with families over time. And I think both of those things are really unique about neonatology.